Friendship Block Party. And we are here all month long talking about friendship. Boys and girls, I hope you're having a great week of school. I miss seeing you at church, but I'm glad you're here for our friendship party. So friendship is using your words and actions to show others you care. And I have a really good Bible story to share with you about a great friendship. And that friendship is between Jonathan and David. But first, let me give you a little history. So back in the time, the Israelites didn't have a king because God wanted to be their king. God wanted those people to worship him and not to worship any other gods. But the people begged God to give them a leader. So Samuel was a great prophet. He actually wrote the book 1 Samuel in the Bible. And so he decided, or God had given Samuel the idea to first make King Saul a king, and then later King David would be the next king. So I have a fun Bible story to share with you about two really good friends. And I kind of need some props. So let me see what I have. Oh, here we go. I have my party supply box. And if you haven't noticed, I have three stuffed animal friends who are gonna help me tell the Bible story today. So I have my props and I have my three friends. So first, let me tell you who our three friends are going to be today. So our monkey here is going to be King Saul. So I'm making a little name tag for them. This is King Saul. Now, because he's the king, he probably needs a crown. So let me see what I have. Well, I don't have a crown, but I do have a party hat. So that will have to work. So that is our King Saul. He's the current king. But remember, it's about time where a new king is about to be become leader. And that was going to be King David. But for right now, we'll just call him David because he's not quite the king yet. So we'll have Mo. This is Mo from Vacation Bible School. He's going to be David. And then this Build-A-Bear right here, that's Jonathan. So I'll write Jonathan. Now Jonathan is King Saul's son. And I'll need my box of props, so I'm gonna leave those right here. And the way it was supposed to work is that King Saul, his son Jonathan, was supposed to be king. But remember, God had chosen David to be king. So here is how the story started. So Jonathan could have been really jealous of David. Because remember, it was supposed to be that Jonathan would be next in line to be king. But here's the thing, Jonathan wasn't really jealous of David. In fact, they were really good friends. And Jonathan even gave David his robe and his belt and a bow. So let's see what I have in my supply box. Ooh. I think this tablecloth would definitely work as a robe. So I'm gonna put this robe around David. Remember, Jonathan was his good friend and he wanted to honor his friend David. And let's see, we can use this party streamer as a belt. So we'll add this as a little belt for David. They were really good friends. Let's see. I'll tie it like this. Wow, David, you're looking nice. And he even gave him a bow. I don't really think it was this kind of bow, but it'll work in our story today. There we go. And along with those things, Jonathan gave him some other really nice gifts too. He gave him a sword. I think this will do. And many other great gifts to show his friendship. Now, however, King Saul didn't think so fondly of David. In fact, he was kind of mad at him all the time. And there really wasn't a big reason, because King David was a really good soldier. And whenever King Saul would send him out to do things, he would do a great job. And I actually think that made King Saul pretty jealous. So King Saul would throw spears at David and try to kill him. Now, I don't have any spears in my party box, but I do have some candles. So King Saul, would try to even kill David by throwing spears at him. So I'm gonna throw some candles at him. Boo! Boo! Now, thankfully, they didn't kill David, but it continued to make King Saul pretty mad and pretty jealous. So Jonathan and David came up with a little plan, and they kind of wanted to see how mad the king really was, because Jonathan was worried about his friend David. So they came up with this plan to see how mad King Saul really was. And if he was really mad, then he would give David a sign and David would know that he should probably leave that land. Now, in our party story today, we're gonna use confetti. So basically, Jonathan said, "Listen, David, if I think that my dad is really mad, I'm gonna sprinkle confetti on this side, okay? But if I don't think he's really mad, I'm gonna sprinkle my confetti on this side." So here was the plan. King Saul had a big feast, and David decided not to go. And they were gonna see how mad King Saul got. So the night of the party came, and David didn't show up, just like he had planned. And King Saul was furious, right? So Jonathan knew that David was in trouble. However, before he sent David away, before he gave him the secret code, he said this to David, and I'm gonna read straight from 1 Samuel chapter 20, verse 14. Jonathan says to David, "But show me unfailing kindness, like the Lord's kindness, as long as I live, so that I may not be killed. And do not ever cut off your kindness from my family." So Jonathan was basically saying, "Listen, I know you probably have to leave this land, but will you please always show me kindness and show my family kindness, even though my dad isn't being very kind to you?" And of course, David said yes. So once Jonathan realized how mad his dad was, he sent the secret signal. Now, that means in our party story that Jonathan sprinkled confetti all over this side. And once David saw that, he knew he needed to flee the land. Now, that is one of the greatest friendship stories in the Bible. Even though Jonathan could have been jealous, even though maybe even if David was killed, Jonathan would have been king, they were friends. And Jonathan wanted to help his friend. And in the end, he ended up doing so. And David kept his promise and always showed kindness to King Saul and to Jonathan. Now, that just goes to show you our bottom line for today. Friends love one another, no matter what the circumstances. So I want you to remember that today too. Friends love one another. So I have a great craft for you today, and it's very simple. All you need is some construction paper, some glue, and if you have some googly eyes or a marker. So what we're going to be making today is a long distance hug. Now, some of you maybe haven't seen some friends or your grandparents for a long time. And this is something that you could make for them, pop it in the mail, and it's kind of like you're sending them a hug. So here's how you make it. You can use any kind of color paper that you have at home. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna first make the big heart. I'm gonna show you guys my secret way on how to make the perfect heart. So I'm gonna use this orange paper today for my heart. I'm gonna fold it in half. Okay, so this side is my side that is folded. This is the folded part, see? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw kind of like half a heart. I'll show you. Just like that, see? And now what I'm going to do is I'm gonna use my scissors, keep my paper folded, and just cut on that part. And then when I open it, so this is what I just cut out. When I open it, it makes the perfect heart. Now I did this one a little smaller than this one, but it doesn't matter. You can make it however size you want. Now we're gonna have some fun with the arms. So what you need for the arms is two strips of paper. If you have a different color, you can use a different color. I'm gonna use green. And it doesn't have to be cut perfect either. So I'm just gonna cut two strips of green. And then here comes the fun part with the arms. So what you wanna do is fold a little bit down and then fold back and then fold forward and then fold back. So you may need to ask a grown-up, your mom or your dad or older brother and sister to help you with this part. So you're kind of going back and forth, and then when you open it, it makes a little accordion. So I'm gonna do that with the other one too. Forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. So now I have my two arms. Now I'm going to cut two smaller hearts for the hands. So I'm gonna use my pink paper for that. And I just need a little bit because the hands are kind of small. Now I'm gonna use my same trick. So I'm going to fold my piece of paper in half, and right where the crease is, I'm gonna draw my half a heart. Now I'll have to do this two times because there's two hands. Cut out this little heart. And let me do the second one. Draw my half a heart and cut it out. Like I said, you can use whatever color paper you have. Are you thinking of someone who you might send your heart to? I might send mine to my sister. She lives in North Carolina. I don't get to see her very much. So now what I'm going to do is I'm gonna glue, or use tape, I'll use glue, my hands to the end of my little accordion strips. And it doesn't matter which side. So I'm gonna glue one heart right here, like that. And I'll glue the other heart on the other one. This is a really easy project, but it's really fun. So now I have my two hearts, my two hands. And oh my goodness, I actually think that I did my heart on the other side, so I'm gonna flip it. I'm gonna flip my heart to the other hand because that's gonna be the left hand. Thankfully, I'm using glue stick, so it comes off really easy. Okay, so now we're ready. So I'm gonna glue, actually I might use tape this time, one hand to this side. And what's nice about using paper like this is it'll fold up really easy. So you'll be able to stick it right in an envelope. And glue on my other hand. Just like that. So cute. So now you can have fun with the face. If you have Google eyes, like I do, you can glue on some Google eyes. If you don't, you can just draw. You can draw whatever kind of face you'd like. I'm gonna draw a real simple face today, but I am gonna put my Google eyes on. And then I just have my marker. Let me show you my Google eyes. He comes alive, hello! And I'm just gonna do a really sweet smile. And I like to do some little freckles for the face. And there we have my hug to go. And it helps us remember that friends love one another. Isn't that fun? Boys and girls, I hope you have a great day today. And I hope you have an opportunity to tell one of your friends how much you love them. Have a great day. Oh, we should end with some music. Oh, and a prayer. You ready? Dear Heavenly Father, thank you today for friends. Thank you for our family. Thank you for school and our teachers. We are so grateful for your Bible stories that teach us what good friends look like. In your name that we pray, amen. Ready to rock it out? Let's go.